Elizabeth Dickinson, Mayor, Saint Paul, Minnesota. So welcome, Elizabeth. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So a couple quick questions to Maria. These are just kind of general. Well, the first question is, what is one quality that you have that differentiates you from your peers who are also running for mayor?
Well, I've been somebody who has taught about active listening, deep listening to people. And as a counselor and as a coach, I think I know how to listen to people in a very deep way. And I'm always interested in what the person that I'm talking to thinks the solution is, and getting that information from people. My dad taught me, I asked him what he was most proud of once. And he said there were three things. One was he was proud of me, and I said, okay. And he said he was proud of supporting my mother to get her college degree. And then he said he was proud of listening. He fixed large mainframe computers. He said he was proud of listening to the women who ran those computers, because when there was a problem, most of the engineers wouldn't ask for what the women thought. And he said he always did, and he always came to quicker and easier solutions because he asked the people. And I bring that to my work. I believe that some of the best answers are going to come from asking people what they think and how they think a solution might come about.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My next question here is, now the superintendent in St. Paul is a very important position, as St. Paul is a very diverse community and the students there reflects exactly what St. Paul is. What are your thoughts on the possibility of working in the future to maybe having a superintendent position being an elected position like some of the other states versus having it as a hiring process? What are your thoughts on that?
That's interesting. That question has never been asked to me before. It's something that I would definitely think about. Do you have examples of other places that have done this?
I can't think of it from the top of my head right now.
Okay.
But, you know, a lot of these candidates who are coming in are from out of state, so they have applicants. So having someone who is from St. Paul, who's been through the system, who knows the system, become superintendent, I mean, that was just something that I thought could be an interesting option, to have someone from the community run the leadership of St. Paul Public School. So just a thought.
No, I agree with you. I think it is, it's often very impactful to have somebody who already knows the system, because then they don't have to learn the system. So I think that could be a really good suggestion.
Thank you. Other question is, what because it is a Hmong forum, I can't ask this question.
Okay.
What was the most recent Hmong function or event that you were at prior to this event?
Prior to this event, I think it was probably sitting down with some individuals who are Hmong, you know, to ask their opinion about things. So it wasn't a function per se, but it was a sit-down meeting.
A sit-down meeting, yeah.
Yes, yes.
Well, that's very good.
And my last question is, I forgot what it is now. So one last question. So when candidates are out campaigning, not just for mayor's campaign or anything at all, but candidates tell community they will do this and do that, and what if the candidates, when they are elected to office and they don't perform and fulfill the promises that were promised, what are some ways that the community should hold the mayor accountable? How should they hold them accountable versus just re-electing them in the next election cycle?
Well, I think it's important that the mayor goes to the community. One of the things that I believe is that you should get outside of City Hall and actually visit with leaders in the community and share what your progress is and where your lack of progress is. One of the things is, one of the attitudes I bring to this is that I see everyone as part of my team. And so that if I am having, if I am being challenged to fulfill a promise, I would want to share that with the community and ask for their suggestions on how to fulfill the promise better. Like, what are some ways? You know, what have I promised? You know, here's the progress that I'm making. Here's where I'm tripping up. Here's where I'm frustrated. How can we work together to make sure that the things that I've promised actually happen?
That's very good. Just on a side note, you know, this is a separate question from asking other candidates, because I thought you did this very well. Something that you did very well was you laid out exactly what you had in mind, your plans, what you wanted to do, versus just saying this is this and this is that. why give away your secret weapon?
Why give away my secret? Why be specific?
Uh-huh. Why is that so important to be so specific?
Well, one of the things that I remember growing up is that my parents were always yelling at the TV at politicians, answer the question. And so I actually find it quite difficult to speak in fluffy ways about things. And I really hold myself to a standard of saying, what can I do that is specific that I can commit to, that I think is possible to do? I actually find that really important, because sometimes I listen to the guys and I go, it all sounds good, but what does it mean? And so I try to be as specific as I can. Yeah, with, you know, at the same time, I don't want to overpromise and underdeliver. But I think most of the things that I have said, you can work on. Even if you can't get all the way there, you can at least get part of the way there. You know?
Yeah. Well, thank you so very much, Elizabeth,
thank
for joining
you.
Us today.
I appreciate it.
Well, good luck on your adventure, and we'll keep an eye on you then. All right?
Thank you. Thank you so much.